So here's what we're going to do. We're going to jump right in. We're a little bit late because I was talking to the team, but here's what I'm going to start with. I'm going to start with this thing you got in front of you here, okay, which is the official signals, okay? And I'm going to kind of just shoot through this list. I think it's a good starting point. I'm going to shoot through this list, and I'm going to explain to you what the heck that official – hey, I got news for you. There's times when I don't know what they called either, okay? And then they give me what's called a yellow card, and I'll get to that in a little bit. Okay, so we'll just kind of go from there. Some of these we need to go through, some of them we don't, but hopefully all you guys have one of these in front of you. Number one right there where it says point winner of the rally. Again, in its most simplistic form, if you want to know who's scoring the points, first thing an official does when they blow their whistle to end a play is point to the team that just scored. Okay, point to the team that just scored. So when you see them point, they usually point to the team that scored, and then they'll tell you why, okay, if there was a violation or whatever the case may be. So that's what that is, okay? Number two, you don't need to know that. That's not going to happen. Number three, a ball inbounds. That one's pretty simplistic, too. She's just pointing in the court to let you know that ball was in the court. So if Alyssa Cavanaugh goes up and hits a ball down the line and it's in the court, she's going to point to our side and say that ball was in the court. Okay, that's what her reaction would be. Okay, Alyssa just hit from over here. She hits a ball on the court. She's going to say, it's our point. That ball was in the court. That's what she's going to say. That's what those signals are, okay? That's a good question. If any part of this ball touches the line, it's considered in. Okay, it's considered in. So any part of this ball hits any part of that line, it's considered in. Okay, it's a good question. Okay, that's a good question. Ball out of bounds, number five. Again, that's what this signal is. That's in. They'll point in. This is out of bounds. The ball was out of bounds. Okay? The ball was out of bounds. You'll also see them do that, those antennas that are on the net. You guys know those candy canes on the net right there? Those candy canes on the net, the ball, that's like an extension straight up in the air of the sideline. That's what that's supposed to be. The ball has to go back inside that, or it can go right over the top of it. It can't be on the outside of it. It's like a foul pole, maybe, roughly. Okay? Yes?
I thought if he had a wide ball going out of bounds to get the ball, it has to go back over the net.
Inside those, it has to go back over the net inside of that antenna. Yep, has to go back over the net inside of that antenna to be in play. Okay? If the ball ever touches that antenna, any part of the ball touches that antenna, it's considered out of bounds. Okay, so if Alyssa Cavanaugh goes up and hits one, and I mean it just grazes that antenna and wiggles it a little bit, then what you're going to see, even though she hammers it to the ground or whatever, you'll see the official blow their whistle and say it's their point, that was out of bounds because it hit that antenna. That's what that's for. Does that make sense? Okay. Number six, ball out of bounds. Okay, now some of these, some of these are, okay, the person up in the chair is called the up official. They're up in the chair. The person on the ground across the net from them, that person's called the down official. They're down on the ground, okay? And then you have the two lines people, okay? The two lines people. I've got a nifty little, this will be interesting for you. That ball's going to drive me nuts rolling around up here. Okay? Look at this fancy little thing. Okay? So, we've got... So they're out of the way. This is the first time I've ever used this thing in my life. Just so you know. Somebody got me this, and they were like, look, it's got magnets. And I'm like, sweet, I'll use that all... No, I didn't. I didn't use it all the time. Okay, so we got an up official... We got a down official, and then you have a line judge here and a line judge here, okay? Always feel sorry for this line judge because they're right by the bench, and I can get in their ear, okay? If you ever see me standing near them like this, yeah, that's probably me, okay? Now, to give you a little something about those line judges, this line judge's responsibility in terms of calling balls in and out, is this line and that line, all the way to the other end. This line judge's opportunity, or this responsibility is this line and that line all the way down. So that's their responsibility. So they have the line judges are responsible for in-out calls. The line judges are also helping with, and we'll get to this one, it'll take a while, the touch calls. When Alyssa goes up and hits that thing and it clips somebody's fingers and, you know, and that line judge, there's some signals for that, okay? And we'll get to all those, okay? Number six, ball out of bounds line judge. Again, they have the flag in their hand. They bring that flag up. That means they saw that ball was out of bounds. Okay? If they put that flag down, it means that they saw that ball was inbounds. You follow me? Now, the dynamic of that, and it drives us nuts as coaches too all the time, is when they see different things. Okay? If one line judge said it was out of bounds, but the up ref can call whatever they see. The line judges are there to assist them. Okay? They're there to assist them. So if the up ref thinks that they see a ball clip the blocker at the net, they have the authority to call that by themselves, no matter. Both line judges can throw their flag up and say it was out, and the up ref would just kind of point at himself and say that there was a touch, and so he has the ultimate authority. That up ref is in control of that deal. Okay? In control of that deal. But that number six is ball out of bounds. Number seven is back to the up ref. You see him up in the stand right there. Ball out of bounds after a contact with a player. That's just a touch signal, meaning if that ball contacted any player, if Rachel Anderson goes up and hits it and it hits off a block and goes out of bounds, then they're going to signal that there was a touch on that play. So they would give it to, this will be us over here, okay? They'd give it to Western Kentucky and say there was a touch off the block. Or they'd give it, if it was a back row player, say they get it past the block and somebody lays out and tries to play it and it clips their hand or whatever, they'd say it's Western Kentucky's, there was a touch. That's what that is, a touch by a player. Means that ball touched somebody, okay? Means that ball touched somebody, okay? And then number eight is the same call from a line judge. You see they got the flag in their hand. That's if they see it touch somebody. They're going to say it touched the flag. That's what their call would be right there, okay? Number nine, antenna fault by a line judge, okay? That's if a ball is hit down the line and the line judge sees that it hit the antenna, then they're supposed to point that it hit the antenna and start shaking their flag. That's what that means. That means that just hit the antenna. And obviously that means it's out of bounds. You guys staying with me here? And you can take this little sheet home with you and it'll help you, okay? Number 10, line violation or center fault. We don't really need to get into that one too much, okay? Number 11 and number 12. Oh, boy. We're going to be stuck on 11 and 12 for a little bit. Okay? Yes. But they're kind of looking for different things. The up ref is the ref that's in charge of the whole match. The down ref, their responsibilities, the one that's standing down on the ground, their responsibilities are to watch for net violations because you cannot, as a player, you are not allowed to touch the net under any circumstance. Okay, so the down ref is standing there while the play's going on. Their focus is on the net. And you're not allowed to jump and have your jersey hit the net. You're not allowed to go over the block and come down and touch the net. All of those kill the play. You're not allowed to touch the net at any point. You can go over the net blocking if you want, but you just can't touch the net. Okay, so that down official is watching primarily for net violations. That's the main thing that they're watching. And they're also in charge of the substitutions. And we'll get to all that a little bit too. I know you're curious about why I take Alyssa Cavanaugh out of the match. She's playing great. Why'd you just take her out? I'll explain all that a little bit, okay? And that's the down official that handles all that. But 11 and 12 are the biggies. Number 11 is a lift. That call is called a lift or a hold, okay? And number 12 is ball illegally contacted, okay? Now let's talk about this one because this one I know is really confusing for you. And this is one that most officials will tell you is the one that gets them in hot water with coaches more than anybody else, because it is a judgment call, okay? It is a judgment call. A lift, this one's a little bit easier, number 11, a lift or a held ball. When a ball, when a player is playing a first contact, like when a ball just came over the net, a pass, a dig, whatever the case may be, the ball may not come to rest on them. The ball, like they can't put their hand out and catch it and throw it up in the air. It has to pop off. It has to hit their platform. They have to hit it with their knuckles. They have to slap at it. It can't, they cannot catch and lift that thing. It cannot come to rest in their hand. If it comes to rest, that's called a lift or a hold or a carry or whatever you want to call it. Okay? And so what you're looking for in terms of a lift is that ball has to pop off in some fashion. The hand can be open as long as it pops off my hand. Okay? But if I catch and throw or catch it and flip it up in the air, that's all illegal. It cannot come to rest. Okay? It cannot come to rest. Okay? Now the next one. A double. Whew, this one, this is the one. Okay? You see this a lot, I'm sure. The referee will blow their whistle and put two fingers up like that. Okay? That's a double contact. Okay? We get three, and again, you probably won't digest everything throughout the day, but you get three contacts when the ball comes to your side of the net. There's a first contact, a second contact, and a third contact. Okay? Stay with me here. Okay? Doubles are called primarily on setters. Okay? The second contact of the ball, which is the one the setter plays, right? You pass it, the setter sets it to somebody, and then they hit it. That second contact, that setter is like your quarterback. Okay, Jess Lucas is our quarterback. They're passing that ball to her just like a center would snap it to her, okay? And she's giving it to whoever she wants to give to, depending on what play we're running, okay? So she's our quarterback, okay? She's our quarterback. So she's handling, if you'll watch us, 95% of the time when the ball comes across to our side, Jessica Lucas is our second contact. She's our setter, okay? When a setter sets a ball, well, they're called setters because they set the ball. When the ball comes out of their hands, that ball is supposed to come out of their hands evenly, okay? And usually, although you're not supposed to call it by the spin on the ball, usually the spin on the ball is what tells you whether the ball was handled cleanly or not cleanly. So on the second contact, if that ball's got a bunch of spin on it, that signifies to them that the ball hit one hand first, the other hand second, and comes out with spin, and that is illegal. That is called a double contact. Okay? That second contact is supposed to come out of their hands like this, with very little spin. See how that ball is coming out of my hands right there? If it comes out like that, that is a double contact. And that is illegal on a second contact. Okay? Now, if you start asking me why on a lot of these, I don't know if I'm going to be able to answer you. I'm just going to tell you the rules. Okay? Yes? Yes, we're going to get to that. That's when we get into the rotational part. But, yes, we do it. We make sure our setter goes to the same spot. And, yeah, we're going to talk about that. That's what I'm going to talk about right after I get through this part. Okay? Yes? I'll get to that one in a second, too. Okay? Yes. Yeah. It's you can't double contact it with one hand. You know what I mean? And Jess, that's getting into some offensive stuff that I hope to get to as well. But that is part of what Jess is one of the best in the country at being offensive herself. We'll get to that. But that doesn't have anything with a double contact. Yes. Okay, that's a good question. Okay? When a ball's hit and the blocker touches it and it comes over, that does not count as one of your three touches. Okay? That does not count as one of your three touches. The block doesn't count as a touch. So if you jump to block and it hits you, that does not count as a touch. You have three contacts after that, okay? And that second one, yes, go ahead. Well, and that second one is the one that double contacts are called on a lot. When a setter, like you'll see a setter on a dead run or they're jumping and trying to make a tough play, you know, jumping and twisting and doing all this in the air. And again, when they do that, that ball is supposed to come out pretty clean. Now, because they're not technically, again, the way the rule reads, they're not supposed to call it on spin. They're supposed to, the official is supposed to have physically seen two different contacts, but come on. Come on, okay? And so different officials, this is your best way to live with this every day, okay? Because it'll drive you nuts, because every official is a little different. Some of them are call it a lot looser than others. There's certain officials that if it does that, they're calling it. There's some officials that it'll do that, and they're letting it fly, okay? Here's the deal, okay? It's like a strike zone. You know what I mean? Some umpire strike zone is bigger than others. Some officials' interpretation of what a double is different, okay? So the only thing we as coaches ask for, and this is where you'll see me, my little bald spot get red sometimes when I'm mad, is you just want it to be the same throughout the match, okay? If you see a kid on the other side and she sets a ball and it does that and he doesn't call it, I usually wait to see the next one, you know? And then if Jess does that, the ball, because Jess did it some today, the ball would come out with a little bit of spin, and some matches she'd get called for that, some matches she wouldn't. And so what you're just really looking for is just make sure whatever you're calling, that's what we live by. What drives you nuts is when it spins two or three times and they don't call it, and then right at the end of the game you set one, it's got a little spin on it, and all of a sudden they blow their whistle. That's what drives you nuts, okay? But by the letter of the law, that ball's supposed to come out of Jess's hand with very little movement. That's okay. But if it's got a lot of spin on it, that's usually going to get called a double on a second contact, okay? Now, the first contact, when the ball comes over, you can, and I know this is weird, but I didn't make up the game. I just coach it, okay? When a ball's served, sometimes you'll see a player just put their hands up like that and kind of throw it to Jess, okay? That's because it is legal to double contact a first ball, okay? It's just not legal to do it on the second ball or the third ball. You'll also see sometimes where, like, we'll dig a ball and then somebody will pop it up in the air, and then, you know, Sydney Engel will just run in there and put her hands on it and just send it back across the net because it's our third contact. And if that ball comes out with a lot of spin, that's a double too. So you can double the first one. I need a pen. Everybody needs a pen for this, don't you? You can double the first one. You can't double the second or the third one. Okay? Can't double the second or the third one. And that's a call that drives everybody nuts, including coaches. Okay? So that's a double contact. The next one, end of game match, that one's no big deal. That's just switching sides, timeout. That one's pretty simple. Substitution, that's what, if you see that down official handles all the substitutions, like when, you know, Darby comes up to the end line to substitution, when they roll their arms like that, it just means there's a substitution coming into the game. That's all that signifies right there, when they roll their arms, okay? Authorization for serve, yes. No, well, you're getting into some of this tough stuff. No, there is a substitution zone, which is up by the net. But then what confuses you is the libero, which we'll get to what the libero is in a little bit. You'll see kids just running it on and off the court. I'm going to explain it. I promise I'm going to explain it, okay?
Do they have
to bang? No. They do. They just usually have these little handshakes they do and all those kinds of things. But we'll get – don't let me not answer that question later, okay?
I mean, I was thinking the ref.
Stop them?
Yeah.
Well, because when they come up to the net for a substitution, they're supposed to pause so the scorekeeper can write it down. And so they got to pause, and they're supposed to wait for the down official to tell them to go ahead. But sometimes as it goes along, they just kind of get in a hurry and they go, and the ref will stop them and bring them back because the scorekeeper didn't see the number. That's really what they're doing right there, okay? Substitutions, authorization for serve. Again, that one's no big deal. They blow the whistle and do this. That means you can play, start to serve. That's all that is, okay? Illegal service, or ball not released at the time of serve. I've never seen a ball not released at the time of serve. That one's kind of, but you will see this a lot. When you serve, servers have to leave the ground. Their foot cannot touch the line when they serve, okay? Their foot cannot touch the line. So if they stay on the ground, they have to be behind the end line to serve. If they jump serve or kind of do a jump floater serve, they can jump over that line as long as they left from behind it, but their foot may not contact any part of that line. If their foot contacts any part of that line, that's a violation. It's called a foot fault, and they'll blow their whistle, and they'll just make that signal right there to let you know that they stepped on the end line. Jess did that up in Kentucky. I was really happy with her when she did that, because that shouldn't happen. No. Nope. Okay, so that's that. Delay of service, don't worry about that. You'll never see that happen. You can mark that one out. Player illegally touches the net or interferes with the ball on the net side. We need to kind of get to that one, I guess. Because, okay, if a player's in the net, when he blows his whistle, he's just going to put his hand on the net. So if the other team was in the net, he's going to blow his whistle, say it's Western Kentucky's ball, and then lay his hand on the net saying they were in the net. Okay, that's what that is, just laying their hand on the net right there to let you know that they were in the net, which they cannot be in the net. Okay? Double fault, a replay. You ever see this? That just means they're replaying the point. If you're unsure, sometimes there's an inadvertent whistle. Sometimes, occasionally, there's just a big-time disagreement about a call. Like the line judge is sure they saw it in, this line judge is sure they saw it out. Every once in a while, they don't do this very often, but every once in a while, they'll just replay it, take the point off. So if you ever see this, two thumbs up, that means they're going to replay that point. Okay, that means they're going to replay that point. Illegal block, number 21 right there, okay? Where this one comes into play a lot, okay, this is a rule you'll want to know, okay? So what about when that net is there, okay, and the ball is passed, can the other team reach over and touch the ball or not, okay? If the ball, and this one drives coaches nuts too a lot, but when the pass is coming up, if any part of this ball gets in the plane of the net, either team can play it. It's free reign, okay? Any part, it doesn't have to be all the way over. Any part of the ball gets to the net, it's anybody's ball. Okay? If the entire ball is falling short of the net, then this team over here is not allowed to touch it. Okay? It has to break the plane of the net for the other team to be able to touch that ball. And there's a lot of controversy about that. Like, a ball will come up, and where you'll see it a lot is a ball will come up, and like Jessica Lucas, it'll be tight. And she'll go up to set that ball, and she'll set it, and they'll jump over and touch it. And then there's a big controversy, because if she jumped to set it and it got that much in the plane, then it's legal for them to block it. If she jumped to set it and it was only right there, then it's illegal for them to do that, and that's our point. And there's a lot of, and I'm going to be honest. Let me just come clean with this one. I've lost my mind over this call before. Most coaches have. But to be honest, if you think about it, I'm not sure why we do. Because who has a better view of that? Me sitting over there on the bench or the up official who's looking right down the net? You know what I mean? Like, they've got a way better view of that than I do. But I'm just being honest. I've lost my mind over that call before. Okay? But then I always sit down and I'm like, really? You know, I mean, he's like standing there looking straight down that net, and I think I have a better view than he does. Okay? But that's what that rule is. You cannot do that. You cannot jump and block. Okay. Number 22, a player positional fault, wrong server, wrong position, whatever. I'm going to get into the positions in a minute that will explain a lot about our game to you, about where people play and why and all that. That's what's coming after I get done with this sheet. But anytime a team is out of rotation, there is a rotation you have to stay in, an order you have to stay in. And anytime you're out of that order, at any point when the play starts, They'll blow the whistle and they'll do this. A circular motion. That's what 22 is. And what it means is somebody is out of rotation. They're out of order.